After the sunset two Saturdays ago, the tradition and temper of Bristol shined brightly. Today, the Winston Cup Series renews a tradition as old as the sport itself, the Southern 500. A true racer knows the history of Darlington. Those that don't burn fast. The next step for the championship challengers is to try to tame a track that has brought racers more than 60 years of fame and frustration. This is a track that has spawned many names across the years. The track too tough to tame, the lady in black, but most notably, a NASCAR tradition. This is Darlington. And there you have it. There is the starting lineup for the field as given by MRN, the voice of NASCAR, Joe Moore, and Barney Hall. I'm your driver and commentator, Mikey McBlam, starting on the front row this time by, along with the points leaders who are also starting towards the front of the field. Championship implications are a great possibility. It's time to see who is going to survive the lady in black. Pace car is down pit road. It's time to get the race underway. Green flag is in the air. We got through turn one, just a little bit loose off the turn. Ryan Newman all over our back bumper. Ooh, got a little bit sideways. Going into the turn. Ooh, contact with Ryan Newman. Gotta be a little bit careful on these newer tires. We pull away to a 0.6 second lead going into turn one. Turn one's not our strongest turn here. We gained the most time in turn three and four, but we're just having a lot of trouble with the handling. The car's gonna come to us towards the end of the run. Is what I've been able to determine from practice, but right now I'm just trying to hold these guys off as Johnny Benson is making a move on the high side. We take the momentum, ooh, really loose off of four. Barely led that lap there. Barely led that lap as we get to the, try to keep it to the inside of Ryan Newman. Little contact. Boy, really loose. Ooh, Ryan Newman pops the wall just a little bit there. Looks like Jeremy Mayfield is up here. Ooh, slid up the track again. Overdrove that just a little bit. Ooh, slight contact. Jeremy Mayfield falls back a little bit. Here comes Ryan Newman looking to the inside. Johnny Benson looking to the outside. We've led all the laps so far. Trying to keep these guys behind us. Got off of turn two really well that time. Ryan Newman looking to the inside. They're too wide behind us. We're going to try to hold it down here on the bottom of the racetrack. Get a good run off the turn. Ooh, Ryan Newman got a really good run. I had to block that run there. We managed to lead that lap. Just trying to stay dedicated to the bottom as we slide up the track just a little bit. We're going to have to go ahead and let Ryan Newman go. Benson didn't look like he had a good turn two either, as he wasn't able to capitalize on us. We're going to look to the inside here. Can't quite get there. Get a little bit of a run off of turn number four. A little loose, though. A decent run. Here we go. Side by side into turn one. Oh, boy. This is a tight groove racetrack. There's not a lot of room here. Oh, golly. Got loose off of two again. Side by side going into turn three and four. We're down on the apron. Ooh, sliding up the track just a little bit. Side by side with Ryan Newman. We lead that lap. Just barely. Using that side draft to our advantage. Ooh, we overdrove that just a little bit there. Got into Ryan Newman. We were pulling a little bit of a gap on the field, Ryan Newman and I. Newman's looking to the inside, but it looks like we got some company coming up here shortly. Trying to keep it down on the bottom here. Here comes Jonathan Wolf. Jonathan Wolf started in the fifth row. I believe he started either at ninth or tenth, but he's made his way up into the top five, looking for second on Ryan Newman. Ooh, slid up the track just a little bit, slight contact. And now Ryan Newman and Jonathan Wolf are side by side. About to go into turn three and four. We had to get on the brakes a little bit there. Almost overdrove that. Decent turn three and four. Oh, almost dirt. Almost a decent turn four as we slid sideways off the turn. Still managed to lead that lap. Here comes Jonathan Wolf. He's going to go high. We blocked high. He looked low. We're going to block low. Sliding up the racetrack slightly. Oh, he got into our left rear. That could have wound up disastrous. I'm scraping the wall there, getting a nice little Darlington stripe. So I'm watching my rear view, trying not to let these guys by. Oh boy, but I'm messing up here. Oh golly, almost lost it there. Almost lost it trying to get back up on the track after getting on the apron. Jonathan Wolf's all over us. Ryan Newman does manage to inherit the lead back. We have such a good run coming out of turn four. which is where that's where we need to be. That's where the run needs to be. Side by side, we do lead that lap. Oh, did we lead that lap? I'm not sure. And I got my I got my corners mixed up here. So Ryan Newman got a big run off the top on the high side because I drove into turn one like I drove into turn three. This track does require a good bit of concentration. We got a smoker down below, so we got somebody who's going to be out of the race on lap 11 here. But Jonathan Wolff's back up into the picture. So is Tony Stewart. Tony Stewart and Jonathan Wolff started side by side. So they're both up here fighting for the lead. Oh boy. Contact. We inherit the lead back. Ryan Newman's all over our back bumper. He's going to try to look to the inside, but we're going to stay dedicated to that inside as much as we can. We slid up just a little bit. And we got loose coming off. Yeah, we just... I don't know if I want to do anything to fix that. I think that's just going to be the nature of it. Bottomed out just a little bit going into 3 and 4 that time. Oh man, we slid up the racetrack. Sorry, 1 and 2. Pardon me. Yeah, we are fighting to keep Ryan Newman behind us. Looks like Bobby Labonte is also entering the picture here. Jimmy Johnson back there. As well as what looks to be Dale Earnhardt Jr. Oh my gosh, hang on to it, hang on to it. Was not clear. Ryan Newman got into our right rear just a little bit there. Yeah, it looks like Dale Earnhardt Jr. making his way up to the pack. He started towards the middle of the field. Ryan Newman's got help on the outside. Like I said, we do have a good run on the inside. Of turns 3 and 4, come on, keep it. Oh, sideways! Barely managed to keep that under control. Barely managed to keep that under control. Oh, man. I'm gonna come off of turn 2. Looks like they fell back just a little bit, but they'll catch back up to us. Another Darlington stripe, just for good measure, because why not? Gonna go into turn 3 and 4, looks like. We have a decent turn 3 and 4 this time. It looks like Jonathan Wolff had a better turn 3 and 4 than we did. But this car has really come into us right now. It's really come to us. I can feel the tire wear on it a little bit, don't get me wrong. I can feel that, but I just feel like that it's just coming to us. Oh boy, I think we overdrove that. Yes, we did. I just felt it. I felt like we overdrove that corner, and I'm just like, yeah, we did. Sure did. Still managed to lead this lap. 20 laps to go. Jonathan Wolff looking to the inside. Down on the apron, Jonathan Wolff makes contact with us, shoves us up the racetrack. Jonathan Wolff is now inheriting the lead as he dive bombed it down into turn one. We're down on the apron. Pit stops are starting to happen already. We come to complete lap 17. We will look to the inside of Jonathan Wolff there. He started to shut the door, but he decided better of it and Lee gave us a little bit of room, but he had the momentum on the high side. I backed off a little bit there as well. So we go down into turns 3 and 4, side by side, but that's okay. Can we make it? Can we make it? Can we make it? Oh, he still has the momentum. He leads that lap. I was trying to get around him so I could lead that lap. A little contact there. We'll pay back for earlier. Actually, that wasn't my fault. The first one was. Well, they were both my fault. The first one was on purpose, the second one wasn't. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and come down pit road this time by. Jeff Gordon's going to go ahead and get around us. Ooh, contact! Boy, I was worried that Dale Jarrett was going to push us up over the speed limit, but he did not. We're going to go ahead and repair the damage. I think we're just going to go ahead and keep the car the way it is. By the way, got a brand new pit crew, so this should be interesting. Hopefully We don't have any issue with the new pit crew. I know it takes them a little bit to get their stride and everything like that, but I'm hoping for a good clean pit stop, 4 tires and fuel, no changes. We're just going to keep the car the way it is. I know it's a bit of a handful, but it will come to us towards the end like it did there. As long as I don't have somebody dive bomb in the corner on us, and we are out in the way. We have come out 9th. Now here's the problem I have in the practice race. I can't get up through the gears as fast as these guys can. Yeah, so they're going to go ahead and drive right on by me. There's Amy Hicks. How about that? I think she's up in the top 10. Possibly she's up in the top 10. There's Jeff Burton, Jonathan Wolf. Yeah, Jeff Burton trying to look on the outside there, but like I said, we just have such good momentum in turn 4. Got out ahead of Jonathan Wolf, so we'd had a decent pit stop. Oh man, I overdrove that. I'm gonna have to let him go. Not you, Burton. 1 to a customer, please. Oh man, got really loose there. All right, yeah, this car is gonna be a bit of a handful to start, but I think it's going to come to us. As long as we just try to keep our nose clean here, try not to do anything silly. 4 seconds off the leader. We're in 10th. That's kind of interesting, because we had probably one of our fastest pit stops that we ever had, and we still lost quite a few spots. I mean, granted, I gave up 3 of them. I wouldn't think we would have fallen back to, you know, to 10th. So, and like I said, Amy Hicks is up here in the top 10. Going to go ahead and go side by side with Amy Hicks. Oh boy, hang on to it, hang on to it. Oh boy, yeah. Sorry about that, Amy. I need to get up here very quickly. That was for position. Hopefully she can hold off Jeff Burton back there and keep her top 10. We're trying to catch up to old Jonathan Wolf here. We really threw it into turn 1 that time. All right, car's starting to come to us a little bit. We're getting a little bit of speed now. Yeah, this car has definitely got some speed to it. Oh boy, oh, contact with the 18 of Bobby Labonte. I was trying to get off of him, but I guess I wasn't turning enough or something like that. I tried to give him a little bump and run, but I bumped him. Oh gosh, wow, why is the car not turning? It's like the car just shot to the right for some reason. It just went straight into the wall, and I'm not sure what the deal with that was. All right, let's just try to get back into a little bit of a rhythm here. Get my concentration going back. And we have lost the time that we've gained. We were about 3.5 back, but now we're back to 4 seconds. But I believe that we can catch back up to these guys, because I don't think our tire wear is as bad as theirs at this track. And other tracks, your big 2-milers or whatever, California, Michigan, yes, it's terrible, but I think at this track, I think we're better. I think I got a good, decent setup in here to make this work. Bobby Labonte is catching us quick. I mean, we're catching the guys in front of us. Oh, man, come on, car, turn. Come on, turn. There we go. Kept it off. Kept our position there. Still 4 seconds back, so we haven't caught the leader. We're catching the guys in front of us, but we're not really catching the leader just yet. Ooh, had a really good turn 1 and 2 that time. Okay, ooh. And I immediately messed it up by scraping the wall. Didn't mean to do that. Alright, let's go into turn 3 and 4. Let's have a good 3 and 4 here. Let's keep it nice. Smooth, get off the... Yeah, there we go. There's the speed I want. Okay. Keep coming. We're getting there. You can run that apron as long as you don't run the very bottom apron. I'm going to be a little bit careful here because there is a significant banking difference here. not so much as it is in turns 3 and 4. Turns 3 and 4, there's banking, but not as bad. Well, see, yeah, see, I ran the too low there. Yeah, and I didn't get the launch off of there like I wanted to. 3.5 seconds back, so I am gaining on the leader now. Actually, I can see the leader from here. That might be, dare I say it, that might be Dale Earnhardt Jr., a little loose off of two. That might be Dale Earnhardt Jr., who's coming from near middle of the pack. He might be leading this race right now. Man, Bob Labonte's all over me. Well, tried to be, anyway. He slid up the racetrack. I think he might have caught the wall there a little bit. We're catching them. We're catching them big time. Jimmy Johnson is in our sights now. Jonathan Wolf all over Dale Jarrett up there. We go down into turn 3 and 4. Oh boy. Yeah, we're pushing this car really hard now. I mean, we've got speed, but we're pushing it, man.
The leader's got you by about 2 seconds.
2 seconds back off the leader. We're coming. Do we have enough time? Do we have enough laps? Contact with Jimmy Johnson there. It's okay. Just a little rubbing. Rubbin's racing. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes. Push this car, man. Push it. Whew, just over 2 seconds. The leaders are within my sights. I could just... do I have enough time? If I could just get there. Really good launch off of turn two that time. Dale Jr. still leading. Man, we're pushing this car as hard as we can possibly can. Another Darlington stripe.
1.5 seconds
back. Oh man, here we go. Turn 1 and 2. Another good launch off of turn 2. Another good one. Only got a little slightly loose, but we're trying to catch up to Dale Jarrett here. Oh, threw it into turn 3. Coming off turn 4. Oh man, we got loose. That's going to cost us some time. White flag in the air next time. By 2 laps to go. Contact with Dale Jarrett. We shove him up the racetrack. Martin's loose up ahead of us. He gets into the wall. Contact with Mark Martin and Dale Jarrett. We make it through. Top 5. Running it down into turns 3 and 4. Here we come. White flag in the air for Dale Earnhardt Jr. Do we have enough time to get to the front? Half a second back, throwing it down into turn 1. Side by side with Jonathan Wolf. Can we clear him? Ooh, contact. Oh, we got loose. That's going to cost us a little bit. We're going to have to throw it in here as much as we can. We throw it into turn number 3. We're going up to the middle of the track. Oh, Stewart comes up the block. He gets into the wall. Jonathan Wolf goes around us, and we're going to finish 4th place. Dale Earnhardt Jr. has just won this race. Oh, man. Dale Earnhardt Jr., Ryan Newman, Jonathan Wolf, us, and Tony Stewart round out the top 5.
The yellow flag didn't fly at all in this one.
Whoa, that doesn't happen very often. It makes you pay a whole lot more for any mistakes. You don't have the cushion of yellow flags to get caught up.
This has been NASCAR Winston Cup Racing, brought to you by EA Sports and MRN. So long, we'll see you next week at the Richmond International Raceway.
Okay guys, so here are the race results for the Southern 500 throwback race, Mountain Dew Southern 500 here at Darlington Raceway. Dale Earnhardt Jr. hangs on to be the race winner, followed by in second by Ryan Newman. Third is Jonathan Wolf. We finish fourth. Fifth place is Tony Stewart. Sixth place, Dale Jarrett. Seventh place, Mark Martin. Eighth place is Bobby Labonte. Ninth place is Jimmy Johnson. And rounding out the top 10 is Jeff Burton. Excuse me, sorry about that. And here is the rest of the field where you can pick out your favorite driver. Amy Fix finishes 11th. How about that? Winner's purse of $181,000, zero cautions, 10 lead changes. Wow, not bad for a little 36-lap race. Time of race 18:17, average speed of 161 miles per hour, and the margin of victory 0.1 seconds. I mean, they were right there, guys. They were right there. Oh, man. Johnny Benson falls out of the race with a blown engine on lap 11. Scott Wimmer is the only car to finish one lap down. Casey Kane would be the last car on the lead lap. And here are the point standings after Darlington. Dale Earnhardt Jr. still maintains points lead, 157 points ahead of Jonathan Wolf. 184 points back in third is Dale Jarrett, and we are 281 points back in fourth. 290 points back in fifth place is Sterling Marlin. There is the top five, your top five contenders. Not the driver stats, the awards for the week is what I was trying to get to. We got the pole award at the most laps of the race as well, so that's 10 bonus points. Good on us, plus $15,000 in video game cash. Moving up the most spots, we'll go to Jeff Purvis. Jeff Gordon with the fastest lap of the race. Sorry, Jonathan Wolf with the fastest lap of the race. Not surprising there. He was pretty quick. Rookie of the race is Todd Sullivan, and the move of the race goes to Jimmy Johnson. Why did I want to say Richard Childress Racing? He's not a Richard Childress Racing. He's with Hendrick. He's always been with Hendrick. Rookie of the Year is still being led by Chad Chaffin. We now have 14 poles on the season, and next race is the Jackpot 5. So if we do manage to win that race, that's another $1 million for the No Bowl 5 contenders. I'm curious to see who else it is. I gotta look that up. I gotta look up the finishing order of Daytona and see who the top five finishers are, other than myself. And then I'll be able to give you guys a rundown of the No Bowl 5 contenders. Chevy still leading the manufacturing points over Ford. And Dale Earnhardt Jr. is still leading the most last. But we have finally moved beyond Dale Jarrett and got ourselves in the second with 91 laps led on the season. Dale Earnhardt Jr. with 120 laps led on the season. And 84 laps led on the season is Dale Jarrett. Just a few more laps, man. Just needed a few more laps. I just needed. I would not have dive-bombed it the way that I did, you know, to try to get a position if I had just a couple of more laps, man. Just a couple more. The car just comes in long term, you know, like when tires start to wear, they get heated nice and hot and everything like that, man, the car just comes to me towards the end, and I'm just like, man, just a little bit more, just a little bit more, a few more laps, and I probably could have won this race. But I can tell you one thing, Dale Earnhardt Jr. is not making it easy on us this season. He's not making any mistakes like he did last season or season before last, where he was, no, I think it was last season. He was up there and then Dale Jarrett just took it away from him because Jr. just kept having bad luck. So, you know, a bad wreck at Charlotte had really messed that up for him. But man, just a few more laps. Oh, guys, I know I already mentioned this before. I am exhausted. it's been a long week, but man, I'm okay with this finish. I just wish I had a few more laps. But anyway, guys, I mean that's gonna be it for our throwback weekend here at Darlington. It was fun racing the Chevy City paint scheme from Days of Thunder. Thank you, Angel, for that idea. I wasn't sure what I was going to do, but then I got the idea from Angel's comment. He was commenting about Days of Thunder over the summer. So, yep, here we go. We got a Days of Thunder themed race. So I was hoping to bring it into Victory Lane, Cold Trickle style, but I couldn't. Just like I said, a few more laps and I probably could have. That's what I was trying to do. I was trying to run the outside and just drive right around them on turn four, but it doesn't work like that. That's not how it works. But anyway, guys, thank you guys so much for tuning in to McBlam Racing on McBlam Entertainment, where we try to bring a little bit of enjoyment to your day every day. If you enjoy these races, I do them every weekend following the NASCAR Monster Energy Cup Series. Like I said, thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. And I will see you at Richmond.